joy and peace to all the people of the earth. Let's receive the word of God with Reverend Kiluba or Kiluba. May God bless you.
I want to run where the angels have tried.
Très chers auditeurs en ligne,
dear online listeners, dear listeners who follow us on your local radios of your respective cities, I'd love to greet you once more in the name of the Apostle of Miracles. He is the Apostle of Miracles. He came in the world to do miracles. I love this Apostle of Miracles, Jesus. John said to all who received him, all without exception, receive him, and you are going to receive miracles. Hallelujah. I'm thinking of Abraham and Sarah, who received the three angels who were in a mission, and they received the miracles they were expecting. Receive him. Hey, why don't you want to receive this young man of Nazareth? He is the chief apostle of miracles. To all who have received him, to all who believe in his name, he has given them the power of the first miracle to become. What an extraordinary miracle to receive the DNA of God, not to become the children of angelic spirits, but he has given them the power to become. What an extraordinary miracle. The Apostle Paul says, what if we are children, we are heirs and co-heirs with Christ. This first miracle is necessary and important. It is not just a suggestion. It is a mutation of a life from a human spirit to a divine spirit. Hallelujah. If in Adam you have the human spirit, in Christ, the apostle of miracles, you have the divine spirit. This is powerful. It is in the same way that we clothe the earthly one, we shall also clothe the heavenly one. What an extraordinary missionary. Wonderful. He is the chief apostle of miracles. As I said to you in the past, I am a seal, evidence of this miracle. You too are a seal of his work. What did the Apostle Paul say to the church of the Corinthians? You are a seal of my apostleship. And Reverend Kiluba and many others, we are the seals of the apostleship of the miracle ministry of Jesus. We used to be and we have become now through his apostleship. This light came in the world. It came to his own did not receive him. But to all have received him. If you are following me as I speak, you can even put your hand over your phone or your radio. You can say, I'm receiving you. Say in your heart, I am receiving you, Mr. the Apostle of Miracles. And you are going to receive this initial miracle. You are going to become. You used to be, but you are going to become something extraordinary to all who have received him, to all who believe in his name. He has given them the power. There is a power. There is a power that operates miracles in Christ so that you may become children of God, to all who have received him. For me, receiving Jesus was a ritual. If you receive it in a true manner, it's going to be visible in the way you are going to become. You used to be and you are going to become. Hey. I'm thinking of what Mary Magdalene used to be. In receiving him, she became. I'm thinking of the Samaritan woman who had the obsession for marriage, moved from divorce to divorce. She was obsessed for marriage, but she became, because she received at the well of Sychar. Not only did she receive the apostle of miracles, but she led the city to receive the apostle of miracles. And when the city came, they said, we do not believe because of your testimony alone, but we believe because we have heard him, and we believe that he is the savior of all the world. This is powerful. We need to be like a Samaritan woman who received at the well and led her city to receive the chief apostle of miracles. This woman changes those that she went to bring. She said, Jesus, keep for me this vessel. And she ran in the city and said, come and see the chief apostle of miracles. This woman was saved by the spirit of miracles of Jesus. Jesus used the word of knowledge. He said to her what she did and what she was by the gift of miracles. And this woman was touched by this gift. And her message was based on this gift of miracle. She says, come and see the man who told me everything I ever did. Isn't he? Couldn't he be the Christ? As it is written, when he will come, he will teach us all things. She will encounter the apostle of miracles who made an impossible thing possible. The woman said to him, there's no relationship between you, Jews, and us Samaritans. But Jesus said there will be a relationship through a miracle. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son to be able to change lives from sin to holiness. I'm saying to pastors and teachers, why don't you want to preach Jesus? You are preaching your own things. I will know the people who preach Jesus in a true manner by the way their audience is changed. Like Andrew, who invited his brother Peter, come and see the man, the Christ. And when Peter came to Jesus, he said, well, you were called Simon, but now you'll be called Cephas, the rock. Peter became the rock by miracle. I would love that my brothers and sisters who are following me should be able to experience a direct change in their life from sin to holiness. This was the case of the city of Kinshasa. When there was a revival, people used to chase after women. We're now transformed and we are living according to holiness. And they stopped chasing sisters in church to go out with them, but now they were transformed. I'm thinking of Mary Magdalene, of Martha, of Lazarus. Lazarus who received the chief apostle of miracles, because when there was a problem, they said to Jesus, the message twice, the one you love is sick. They were saying, we know that you are the chief apostle of miracles. But he delayed a little because he wanted them to know that he was a chief apostle also of resurrection. There are families that don't live together, but the family of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, they were living together, and together they loved Jesus. In the seven families, only one person loves Jesus. But this family of Mary, Martha, and Lazarus, they all love Jesus. They said to him, the one you love is sick. And the apostle, the chief apostle of miracles, did not fail. You know that the first miracle that he did was in a village. I want to raise through this message missionaries who go through villages with miracles. We also want missionaries who target cities because they want to take things from those cities, but we target souls. This chief apostle of miracles began in a village. Jesus did not begin miracles because he wanted, but he was sent there. I want to say to villages of DRC and of the nations, you are not forgotten by heaven. The great cities can neglect you, as I see the great politicians of the nations. They are always developing cities, but they forget villages. If you do so, you don't have the heart of God. Jesus began by the village. Even myself, I began my ministry as a man of God in the village. The first miracle of resurrection of a child, it was in a village in Chibambo in the territory of Kasenga. It was in the village. Many visions I had, I received them in the village. Do not forget that Gabriel landed in a village to be able to speak to Mary. I am saying to villagers who are trying to move to cities, stay in your village in Kananga. God will come there. I say to Africans who are trying to move from Africa to Europe, remain in Africa. The apostle of miracles will find you in Africa. Stay in Bujimai, in your village. Call him, he will come there. And you who are called to go and minister in villages, go there. Why did Jesus begin his ministry in a village? I want you to imitate Jesus. What matters to heaven, it is not the city or the village, it is a human being. No matter where the human being is, in a city or a village, God will come there. That is why I greeted you in the name of the chief apostle of miracles. He still does miracles again and again. There is a song sung in the French-speaking countries. They sing, God still does miracles. He's alive. He came into the world to do miracles. There's a miracle of change as long as you receive him. I would love that people should receive the miracle worker in order to be changed into a new life. The Apostle Paul experienced a miracle not in a city or a village, but on the road. That is why send people on buses, on the streets. Jesus evangelized Paul on the road. He would have evangelized him in Jerusalem or in Damascus, but he chose to evangelize him on the road. It is on the road that Paul received Jesus of Nazareth. You can receive him anywhere, on the street, on the hospital bed. As you are following me, raise your hand and say, I receive you, the chief apostle of miracles. He will come where you are. As it is written, to all who have received him, to all who believe in his name, he has given them the power that changes. What is more difficult, to change water into wine or to change a sinner into a righteous? It is the great miracle to all who have received him. I'm thinking of those who were invited at the wedding of Cana. They received him at the wedding, and there he did the first miracle. Received the one to whom God gave them angels to do miracles in all the earth. The one who said, truly I say to you, when he said to Nathanael, Nathanael also was saved by the gift of knowledge, word of knowledge. Jesus said, before you came, I saw you under the tree. There are times where God, I was in a place the Lord would open my eyes to see things that are far. And I would say to a person, you were in a car, in a Hilux, you said this and this, and I saw you. It is not magic. It is the means of heaven to be able to save the Samaritan woman and Nathanael. And what did Jesus say to him? He says, truly you see heavens open, and angels moving up and down on the Son of Man. And the man came and he said, you are the King of Israel. The angels were with the chief apostle of miracles in order to lead people to see heaven. He is with God so that the four corners of the earth should see miracles. We need to know that he is that. Let me go in my topic. It is not far from what I'm saying in the introduction. In my topic, there are miracles in the miracle. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hey, 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 hey. They are miracles in the plural, in the miracle, in the singular. Hey, 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 hallelujah. In Mark 16, verse 15 to 18, that is our main scripture. Then he said to them, go into all the world. The whole world has a right to miracles, and preach the gospel to every creature. Why should we preach? Because there is a power of God. Do not seek for the address of miracles anywhere. The address of miracles is in the full gospel. It is in the gospel. It is Paul who says to the Romans, Romans 1:17, I'm not ashamed of the gospel. It is a power. There is in the gospel the power, the power, the power of miracles. The initial miracle for the salvation of whosoever who believes, first of the Jew and then the Greek. It is for the ignorance available, the miracle of salvation. Jesus says again and again and again, salvation is a miracle. Salvation is not an initiation. It is not a ritual. It is a power. That is why I'm saying to people, preach the gospel. There is a power of miracles. Then he said to them, go therefore into all the world and preach them the gospel. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. 17, and these are the signs that will follow those who believe. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Believe. Believing is a miracle. And believing leads you to the miracle of salvation. I say to church, go further. Jesus is informing us. He says, he who believes will be saved. The first miracle, salvation. That is why I say in my topic, there are miracles in the miracle. Hallelujah, hallelujah. There are miracles in those who are saved. May you come back to what you have. There are miracles in those who are saved. The first miracle, it begins here. Those who believe will be saved. And behold the miracles that will follow. Hallelujah, hallelujah. A river of miracles that follows you until the end of your life. Hallelujah and hallelujah. Behold the miracles and signs that will follow those who believe in the whole world to this gospel. Hallelujah. I just wanted to awaken your mind and attention to what you have. Behold the miracles that will follow. Hallelujah. The miracles that are in the reach of the first miracle, salvation. When you are saved, you have a right to the next chapter, miracles. What is weird is that Christians are seated in churches and they are just content with their salvation and waiting for the return of Jesus. And I'm saying to them, what have you done with the miracles that Jesus said? Behold the miracles that will follow those who believe. Number one, the miracle of salvation that leads you to be a believer and following a festival of miracles. I call it a festival of miracles. There shall be showers of blessing sent from the Savior above. Jesus gave his spirit that the Holy Spirit may flow again. River of grace. Source of the promised joy. The drought has given way to the river of the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
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 If you believe and I believe and together we pray, the Holy Spirit will come down and Africa will be saved. Miracle number one. But Africa, do not stop on the first miracle. There are miracles in the miracle. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I have a complaint against pastors who complete their sermons without praying for miracles to happen. Come back, come back. Verse 20, they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word to the accompanying signs. Pray for miracles. I'll come back. Being a preacher, it is already a miracle. Not just these preachers who speak anything. I'm talking about anointed preachers. It is someone who said to Saul, he says, when you will have left me, you will be changed into a new man. And people will say, Saul has begun to prophesy. It was the first miracle of Saul. But in the miracle of the preacher, I'm thinking,
c'est un miracle lié au docteur.
The teacher, Dr. Lubenga,
I'm
saying, bring to us money. Because the Bible says, he who is taught must bring all he has to the one who teaches him. You who teach need to also bring in finances. It means that in the miracle of teaching, there is the miracle of prosperity, co-prosperity. There are miracles in the miracle. That is why these people went and preached everywhere. The Bible says the Lord was with them, confirming their words with signs and wonders. I want to marry everyone to the right partner who is the power of miracle. Make the power of miracle your partner in all you do. It is Jesus who said, behold the miracle that will follow. There are people who are glad to have children, but they have no miracles. And when children are sick, they are agitated. Behold the miracles, the miracles that will follow. Behold the miracles that will follow those who believe. That is why I call it the miracles in the miracle. I was speaking to believers in general that there are miracles in their miracle of salvation. I also spoke about teachers and preachers that there are miracles in their spiritual nature of being anointed beings. There are miracles in their being. That is why they went everywhere preaching the gospel. They went to speak. There are miracles in your nature as preachers. That is why the Bible says, he who gives a glass of water to a prophet will receive the prophet's reward. May you receive provision in your status as anointed beings. May you become anointed in order to perform your duty as preachers. And you receive from your duty. You need to first work to receive. There are certain people who are thieves who want to take before they do their duty. Think of doing your duty before you receive. There are certain preachers who are in a congregation of 1,000 people. Instead of performing their duty, they first want to receive. They will organize a sermon in order to receive. We don't want that kind of people. I'm talking about people who have a duty to do the miracles. Don't be a preacher by ambition. I'll say to people, before I preach, I don't know how I will preach. Every sermon is a new beginning. That is why I pray before I preach. If the Holy Spirit is not on me, nothing will happen. Everything that David did, it was the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of God was upon him from that day until the end of his life. Many people say, Pastor Kinuba is like that. He will begin in a small manner, and afterwards it's like a fire that is switched on. I say to people, it's a miracle. I'll start running in every direction. I am not dragged. I am filled with the Holy Spirit, and I have the prophetic excitement. Sometimes I'll speak from morning until the evening. People will say, it doesn't end. I say to you, it is a miracle to be a preacher. It is a miracle. Even Jesus said, the words that I speak to you, it is not me, it is my Father. One day there was a man of God who was speaking, who was saying that I was speaking in Osaka, in another place. He said that I feel like a voice was coming out of me that was not me. one day I spoke in the crowd, it was like smoke coming out of my mouth. But in this miracle of preaching, as we read, they went everywhere preaching, and the Lord was with them, confirming their words with signs and wonders. Don't just put on the anointing of preaching. There are miracles in the miracle you're experiencing as preacher. I'm saying this to redirect preachers who are wasting the grace of miracles in the miracle. Because they just talk on saying, people say, I preach good. I say, small preacher, go beyond that. Do miracles in the name of Jesus. Gold and silver I don't have, but such as I have, in the name of Jesus, those who receive this message, who are teachers and preachers, who start praying for miracles. Even Jesus, in John 14, he says, the words that I've spoken to you, it is not me, but my Father. He says, the works that I've done, not me, but my Father. The two work together, words and works. Let's change the way that we work to please the one who has anointed us. In the miracle of salvation, Jesus sees a river of miracles. This message and word coming from Christ that was transmitting miracles. Behold, the miracles that will follow those who believe. First, the initial miracle of salvation. Let us work for this miracle, but not stop at it. The believers in Christ, they are storerooms of miracles. That is why I say to brothers and sisters, go to church. Don't miss church, because church is a storeroom or storage of miracles, warehouse of miracles. Where two or three are gathered, 30 or 50, God will do miracles. I say to pastors, leave the believers to experience the miracles of the miracle. Jesus didn't want us to only enjoy of the miracle of everlasting life. Behold the miracles that will follow those who believe. That is why my topic is entitled, that there are miracles in the miracle of salvation. Let us come back to this truth of the gospel in order to see the power of the gospel. I love that we may see the power of the gospel. I'm not ashamed of the gospel. It is a power, hallelujah, for the salvation of those who believe. Preach in the universities, preach in the markets, preach everywhere. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. For the power of God, for the Jews who are ignorant, for the Greeks who are educated, let it be the illiterate or the educated. The salvation will not come through any ritual, but only through the power of God, and to all those who believe. To all who believe, He has given the power of salvation. I believe in the power of salvation for your cities and your nations. There is the power of miracle, the initial miracle, and other miracles. In Mark 16, verse 20, they went everywhere preaching, and as they were preaching, they didn't know that God made available to the gospel miracles. The Lord was with them, confirming their words by signs and wonders that followed them. Let me read Acts of the Apostles, Acts chapter 5, 19 to 20. But an angel of the Lord who had opened the prison doors and brought them out and said, verse 20, go and study the temple and speak to the people all the words of the life of this life. Verse 12 of Acts 5, and through the hands of the apostles, many signs and wonders were done among the people, and they were all with one accord in Solomon's porch. Yet none of the rest there joined them, but the people esteemed them highly. Many miracles followed those who were preaching. Don't just speak anything. There are people just who speak useless things. We do not speak just anything. we speak of the gospel. Romans 1:16-17. I am not ashamed of the gospel. It is the power of salvation for the Jews first and the Greek that follows. For in the righteousness of God is revealed from faith to faith. As it is written, the just will live by faith. We need men of God who know what the gospel represents. I say to people, as preaching is already a miracle, there is already miracles in this miracle. So the problem is that people do not believe that God will hear. But already preaching is a miracle. You open your mouth and God begins to move. In the same way, do the same thing. Lay your hands and God will do these things. I know these things. First speak and then miracles will follow. Why is it that you leave the miracle as you speak, but you don't believe in the miracle as you lay hands? Many preachers will say, what Reverend Kiluba is saying is the truth. We don't know what we will say in the beginning. When I start, I know that God will not let me down in the public eye. I know that He will move as I speak. That is what we read in Mark 16, verse 20. In the same way, the Lord was with them, confirming their words with signs and wonders. First, Christ released you, the first preacher. He made you a best-seller preacher. He, hallelujah, hallelujah, is with you. And after that, He will move to the second phase. He will work with you. Pray, pray, pray. My time is moving. There is miracles in the miracle. A preacher by miracle to do miracles. I am an old preacher in the church. I know what we face as we preach. Sometimes we speak and then we begin to now just send people to go home. No, don't send them away. Preach to them in faith. A preacher of, by miracle followed by miracles. Galatians 3. Verse 5, he who does miracles in your midst, does he do it by the supply of his spirit or by the works of the law? Lead him to do miracles by the preaching of faith. Hey, hey, hey. You speak to the preachers. Have a good vision of your anointing. And Jesus had a good vision of his anointing as a preacher. Our time is gone. In Luke chapter 4, Jesus is aware of his anointing. Luke chapter 4, verse 18. What does he say? The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. I can feel him right now. He has anointed me to preach the good news. He didn't stop there. He goes further. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to declare to the captives their freedom. Those are miracles. To lay, to release those who are bound, to declare the year of favor. Number one, the anointing of the word. You know how Jesus was anointed. That is what the disciples of mine said. Do you know about Jesus was a powerful prophet in word and in works? May you be a dual personality, powerful in word, powerful in works. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That was the anointing of Jesus. And he proclaimed it himself, anointed to speak, anointed to do. Speak and do. How can I help you? That is what he told in John 1, in John 14, 12. Whoever believes in me will do the works that I do. Our time is complicated. The works that Jesus did, it was miracles. Not only he spoke, but also he did. And I love that it should be with you, dear pastor, that you may do what he did. Not only he spoke, as Paul in Galatians, in Ephesians, in Ephesus, wherever he went, the luggage of miracles of the missionaries is their faith. Some people don't have the suitcase of miracles, the luggage of miracles. It is faith. As the miracle, as the missionary Moses was sent by God in Egypt, he bought the luggage of miracles. It was the staff. Moses said to God, with what am I going to save the people? God said to him, what do you have in your hand? He says, I have a stick. And all the miracles of Moses was in his stick. There is in your faith all the luggage of miracles. Don't forget your luggage in the mission. Moses is better than our missionaries. He didn't want to just go with nothing. He says, what shall I go? What will go with me? And God says, I will put miracles in your stick. And I said to the others, behold the miracles that will follow those who believe. It is in faith that there is the miracles of the miracle. The miracles are in the luggage of faith, in the suitcase of faith. I would love to share with all the nations the suitcase of miracles, the faith for miracles. I give it to you freely, in the same way Jesus gave it to the apostles. You receive freely, give it freely. It says, first preach the kingdom, and then purify the leper, heal the sick, cast out devils, raise the dead. If Jesus gave to them the suitcase of miracles, I give it to you today as I speak to you. Believe me, and you are going to receive the suitcase of miracles. That is a faith. The time of miracle is not finished. It is just the beginning. I heard a theologian who said, let's demystify the gospel. I said, stop giving us strong theological words. You are in a lack of faith. Because in the gospel there is miracles. We cannot demystify the gospel. The gospel is accompanied by spiritual works. I don't know this theologian from Germany. Miracles follow the gospel. The gospel is followed by the spiritual. The miracles, we are following the gospel. Let me say to you one more thing. You are following me. The epistle to the Hebrews is painting the picture of miracles that are available in all ages. When you see Hebrews 11, from Abraham to Moses, throughout the generation, there was faith for miracles, faith for miracles. The time for miracles will not pass as long as the time of faith has not passed. No matter the age of the people, people who came after them, the same causes produce the same effect. Faith will produce miracles today, tomorrow. The Bible says it's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus Christ is the same. 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 Yesterday, today, and forevermore.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. It is a matter of faith. May the Lord help you. We don't have time to speak other things. Miracles are available in the present age. Don't we have believers in the 21st century? It is not a matter of time, it is a matter of faith. Didn't I say to you, if you believe, you will see the glory of God? It is not a matter of time or place. Faith makes miracles possible in all time and in all place. We'll say other things. In the miracle, there is a resurrection of Jonas. There was also the miracle of the repentance of the great city of Nineveh. There are miracles in there are miracles in the miracle. Jesus said, we will not give you another miracle if not the miracle of Jonah, who spent 3 days and 3 nights in the belly of the fish. And in the miracle of Jonas was the miracle. Jesus was to die and after 3 days resurrect, and at his resurrection repentance would be preached in his name, beginning with Jerusalem. Hallelujah and hallelujah. What are you doing with the resurrection of Jesus? There is the miracle of repentance in the resurrection. Hallelujah. Until next time, amen and amen.
Thank you for following. Let us spread faith all around the world.